या हाय सिद्धार्थ, हाउ आर यू?
I'm fine with that.
या यू हैव इंटरव्यू विथ न्यूट्रल मैन टेक्नोलॉजीज टुडे, राइट? कैन
Yes.
वी स्टार्ट?
Yeah.
या हाय सिद्धार्थ, टेल मी समथिंग अबाउट योर प्रोफेशनल एक्सपीरियंस एंड योर एजुकेशन डिटेल्स.
Hi Venkat. I am Siddharth. I am
ओके
from Andhra Pradesh. I am complete my graduation in Loyola College, Vijayawada.
ओके
Okay. Overall, I have 3.1 years of experience in SAP HD model with implementation support.
ओके
Okay. My first company was KVN Technology Private Limited from 2018 to 2019. Sorry, 2020.
Okay.
Due to some reason, I left from that company. Later, I was joined in DD Technologies.
Okay.
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 My first project was Nature Private Limited.
Okay.
In that project, I worked as a junior consultant. Like I involved in the requirement gathering phase, and I prepared BPP document, and I tested all scenarios with different test data, and I prepared given training to end users.
Okay.
Okay. Later, GM, Y Automation Private Limited.
Okay.
For that project, I am in like I'm the lead consultant for SAP HD module.
Okay.
Yeah, I took requirement from the client, and I prepared BP document, and I took sign off, and I configured all scenarios based on the client requirement, and I involved unit testing and integration thing.
Okay.
Test scripts, and I given training to end users.
Okay.
Okay. Currently, I'm working in the LD.in groups.
Okay.
In this project, my major work is the monitoring the adoption background jobs.
Okay. Yeah. Come to your first project, Nature Private Limited. Are you how many members worked from SD?
Two members. A
Two.
Senior and I'm the junior.
Okay. What is your role there?
Just I am supporting to senior.
Okay.
Like I junior consultant.
Yeah, you mentioned worked on S/4HANA with project systems. What is main integration between SD and project systems?
Yeah, in this project, major orders delivery. I mean, usually we are doing delivery order invoice, right? For this, for in this case, we are doing delivery from project, not from this order.
Okay.
Okay. Budget costing and everything will capture under PS.
Okay. In which transaction level?
Yeah, in project creation CJ20N. Okay.
Okay.
But we are doing delivering from a CN0 T code. Through the T code, we are doing delivery from project.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. After that, we have to go to VL02N. There we have to do PGA.
There is no sales order.
Sales order is there.
Okay.
The sales order is there. We have to link that project WP settlement to sales order.
Okay.
Okay. In sales order, we have billing tab. We have account assignment tab is there. There we have to assign our WP settlement.
Okay. In sales order level, you can assign WBS element, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Why we are using WBS? What is the use with WBS element in sales order?
We are creating the one project, but before that we are getting order from the customer, right?
Okay.
That order we have to link to our sale our project. That one and only control is the WBS element.
Okay, okay. Your costing and revenue, everything you can book with WBS instead of FI entry, FI order,
yes.
Right? Okay.
Yes, everything from project.
Yeah. Have you worked on business partner in your first project itself?
Yes.
Yeah. What is the difference between business partner and ECC customer master?
Yeah, in ECC we are creating the customer like XD01 decode. Okay.
Okay.
For ECC, for vendor master, decode is different. For custom master, decode is different.
Okay.
Okay. In
Okay.
B, in S/4HANA, they merge all custom, all business, all transaction one decode, like a BP. It's a vendor, customer, everything we can create under BP decode.
Okay.
Okay. Different here in S/4HANA, we have to create BP account group separate and a customer account group separate.
Okay.
Those two account group we have to synchronization.
Okay. You have mentioned credit memo and debit memo. What is the difference between credit memo and debit memo and normal invoice?
Yeah, sometimes normal invoice. What normal invoice? We are raising invoice to customer. I mean, we are taking money from the customer for material price. Okay.
Okay.
For credit memo, whenever we dispatch material to the customer, sometimes we are raising more amount from the customers.
Okay.
Okay, that time we have to create. Whatever we take more from the customer, those amount we have to create to them. So
Why
that scenario we are going to the
customer paid more amount to you without any document
come
reference?
come come come. We need document reference. You won't pay any amount. Whatever we agreed between the company and customer, he will pay that way, that much only. By mistake of end user,
Okay.
okay, he raised more amount. That's why that customer asking to why I have to pay more amount. My agreed amount is 100 rupees only. Why I have to pay 110 rupees? That's why we are going to credit 10 rupees to the customer.
Okay. Have you worked on credit management in S/4HANA?
Yes.
What is the major difference between ECC and S/4HANA credit management?
Yeah, in ECC and S/4HANA, but concept-wise, there is no difference between ECC and S/4HANA, but configurations-wise, we have a lot of difference between ECC and S/4HANA.
Okay.
Okay. In ECC, through FD32 decode, we are capturing the customer credit limit, credit limit, and what is the customer priority. It's a low customer, high customer, medium customer. Okay. Those
Okay.
information we can capture at BP level. We can capture at BP level only in one ticket. BP in customer master BP ticket only we can capture that information. We
Okay.
have the for credit manual, we have the role is the UKM000.
Okay.
Okay. In that role, in that credit manual role, we can maintain our credit customer credit limit and what is the customer priority.
Okay. Handling unit, what you have done in handling unit, why we are using in SD8? Hello?
Yeah, handling units. Handling is nothing but your packages. Okay, packing material configuration.
Okay.
Actually, it's long time I forgot that concept.
Okay, no
So I
issue.
have to look into. I have to look into again.
Okay, what is the major concept configuration step or automatic batch determination?
Yeah, in item category determination, in item category, we have the on field is the automatic batch. That
Okay.
we have to check.
Okay, configuration level. Have you done anything in strategy group level?
Yes, but this one also I have to look into this.
Okay, why we are using status profile?
For it is for authorization purpose, we are going to use the status profile.
Okay, you mean approval purpose? We are using status profile.
Yes.
Okay. You mentioned availability check. I can ask you one question on delivery scheduling in availability check. I have
Okay.
party materials available in my stock. Okay. Customer
Okay,
created
okay.
sales order for 100 goods. Okay.
Okay.
My RLT time is replenishment lead time is 5 days. Okay, picking
Okay.
time 2 days, packing time picking and packing both time is 4 days. Okay, 5 days RLT, 4 days picking and packing time.
Pick
Okay, pick pack time. Okay,
back. Okay.
pick pack time. I have created sales order for 100 goods today. Only 40 goods available. Customer requested delivery date is 25th. That means tomorrow.
25th.
Yeah. How system
okay.
Can schedule delivery?
Yeah. First, system will confirm the 40 quantity after 4 days. Why? Because of already we have 40 stock.
Okay.
Okay. System will calculate the pick pack time. It will confirm. Today's date is 28th. It will confirm 40 quantity. Already we have stock 40.
20.
Okay.
20
remaining is 28th.
Okay. Why 28?
After
already my stock is available. Why 28th?
Yeah, we have to calculate pick pack time, right?
Yeah. Good. Okay. What about remaining 60?
Yeah. Remaining 60 system will calculate after 9 days RLT time plus pick pack time. Nine means it will confirm July 3rd and remaining 60.
Is it backward scheduling or forward scheduling?
Yeah, in first 40 quantity the backward scheduling. Okay, another 60 quantity the backward forward scheduling. It will calculate from the order date.
I hope.
Sorry. Both are forward scheduling.
Yeah. Okay. Because tomorrow is 25th is
requested
delivery date. There is 4 days for pick pack time, because a system will calculate it forward scheduling. Because today is the order date.
Yes, correct.
1 day is there, but 4 days they required it. Okay.
Yes, correct.
Yeah. Good. Have you worked on pricing?
Yes.
What is the used with alternation calculation type? Alternative calculation.
Yeah, it is the yes.
In pricing process.
Yeah, it is the formula.
Is there.
Okay. Whenever.
Yeah.
Yes, correct. Yeah, it is one of the formula. If you maintain formula in calculation time, system will calculate and propose the condition value. Okay. If you for this one, no need to maintain the condition records.
Okay. What is the use with base type?
Yes. Yeah, it is also same, like it is also like a formula. If you maintain formula and base type system calculate proper the base value.
Okay.
For this one, we need to maintain the condition records.
Can you example one scenario?
Yeah, for VPRS condition type is zero. For VPRS condition, we are going to maintain the 22 at base type.
Okay.
For 22, that is one of the formula, but back, I'm not aware on the practically, theoretically, I have knowledge.
Okay. From where VPRS condition type, from where this value is picking, we are not maintained any condition records, or it will not allow manual price, from where this price will pick VPRS price.
It is picking from the material master. We are accounting tab. We have the standard price is there. From there, it is picking.
Okay, only standard or any other price also is there?
Standard and moving price, two prices.
Moving average.
Actually,
yes. How system calculate profit margin?
Profit margin.
Yes.
Yeah, base value minus discount equal to profit or
profit margin.
Right? Yes. Net gross value minus net value equal to profit.
I hope it is wrong. Your net value
Sorry.
Minus VPRS. Your material cost equal to whatever remaining
correct.
Is there, that is profit margin. Okay.
Yes, correct.
Yeah, output determination. Have you worked on ECC output determination?
Yes.
Where I can assign my output form template, output form. Where I can assign output form with the document.
Yeah. Yes, we have output types is there. In output type, we have one of the tab is there, or is the condition routine.
Okay.
In there, we can option it forms. There we are going to assign.
Okay. Instead of manual entry in of output in my invoice, I want automatically it will pick output type. How we can do? Is there any condition
Yeah,
records?
yes. For we have the output condition records is there for sales order VV11, for deliveries VV21, for invoice VV31.
Okay.
Okay.
What is
If you made a
standard
condition,
output type for intercompany invoice?
intercompany invoice. For
Yes.
invoice, we are using RD01. For a particular intercompany, I don't know. I am not aware.
Okay. No issue. Yeah. Have you worked on intercompany sales?
No.
No. Have you worked on stock transfers?
I am.
Yeah. What is
No, I'm.
the
But I'm not. I am aware of the STO.
Okay. Copying controls. What is the major steps for order to order in copying controls? Major steps means like sales document, item category, schedule and categories is
Yes.
required. Order to delivery.
Yeah, for order to delivery, for copying routine is the 00002.
No, I'm not
Okay,
asking
it will
that.
come.
Here also header, item and schedule lines are required.
Okay. Like, okay, yes. No, here only item, header and item.
Why schedule line is removed here? Not using.
Yeah, actually, we are not showing any schedule lines at delivery level, right? There is no, we are not flowing any scheduling data to delivery. Just we are flowing the data from order to delivery, the header and item.
Okay, have you worked on item categories?
Yes.
There is a billing relevance field is there. What is the use with billing relevance field?
Yeah, it will control how we have to bill to customer. It is order related billing or delivery billing or pro forma invoice. It will control that.
Okay. Yeah, there is one item is there. That item level system will not pick pricing. What is the major controls for that?
System on pick the price means in I first we have to check at our item category level price field maintained or not.
Okay.
Okay, if it is blank, system will not pick the price at order level.
Okay. Have you worked on cash sales?
No, but I have run cash sales.
Okay, what is the accounting entries in cash sales invoice level?
Yeah, customer cash sale account debit to revenue account credit. Sorry,
I hope it is petty cash.
yes, correct.
Okay. And how many company codes are there in this first project, Nature Private Limited?
One company.
Okay, what is the main business source for Nature Private Limited?
Yeah, here they are making the storage systems.
Okay.
Yeah, it is like a it's a duration, it's 6 months duration project. So they have to capture the all schedule lines. Okay, all the cost, everything they have to capture. That's why we are going to PS.
Okay. Here one support project is there in DD Technologies. So that project name is Healthy Dot In Groups. Okay. What is the business nature here?
Yeah, it's like a order to cash, but we have a lot of systems integration. There is a worldwide company, I mean the worldwide business is there. Okay,
Okay.
every day we are creating orders. Those all orders users are it's not possible to create manual. It's
Okay.
not, so we are going to use the through batch we are creating the deliveries.
Okay.
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 And we have a lot of integration between some customer systems to our SAP. So we are going to that one as IDOC.
Okay.
So major, here I have to monitor the IDOCs and background jobs. Is there any IDOCs where I
Okay.
have to take action?
Okay. What is the functional consultant role in IDAX?
Yeah, functional consultant role, we have to, I mean, in support, right? Implementation, just I have knowledge, but support,
Yeah, tell me your knowledge.
In support project, we have to monitor the IDOCs. Is there any IDOC failed? We have to analyze why it was failed. Okay, after analyze, is there a after analyze, we have to reprocess the IDOC.
Okay. What you have done in IDAX in this project? What is your role? What is your regular activities in IDAX and background jobs?
First I have to check if the IDOC is failure success. If
Okay.
it is fail, sometimes I'm getting the tickets from the users. They are asking to add the segments.
Okay.
Okay, sometimes they will ask to reprocess the IDOCs.
Okay.
Sometimes they are asking to delete the IDOCs. Sometimes based on the ticket, I am going to do actions.
Okay.
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 For background jobs also, we are based on secret. Sometimes users will ask to hold these jobs. Sometimes they're asking to rerun the jobs. In case if there any job fail, I have to analyze and I have to rerun those jobs.
Okay, why they have used IDAX in your system? What data they are sending to other system? What is the other system? That
Yeah, it
system
is.
is related to SAP or non-SAP?
That is related to SAP system. That is a LH1. Like this invoice values, the document values we are posting to the other systems.
Okay.
This order deliveries we are getting from this non-SAP like a customer systems.
Okay.
Those customers through IDOC we are getting orders in SAP system. In SAP, the orders will create through background jobs. Delivery invoice will create after invoice through IDOC. We are sending that document value to the other systems.
Okay, have you worked on subcontracting?
Yes.
What is the subcontracting in SAP SD, sales and distribution?
Here. Outside at this point of view, we don't have any process. Okay, we have to do some configuration. Actually, this process is whenever, for example, in my company, we are they are not they have not any mission to paint that iron. I mean that materials. So they are sending those material to other person for painting.
Okay. Which process you have used
Okay,
for
so
this?
this will consider as a sub for painting. In my nature company, they are sending the material to the vendor for painting purpose.
Okay.
Once he pay, once he done, a vendor done the activity, again he will send that material to the company. Then company will do it will make it will may it will use to for making the product.
Okay. What is the difference between unit testing and integration testing?
Yeah, unit testing just each and every model they can test their self. Okay,
Okay.
integration module we have to test full cycle end to end.
Full cycle means?
We have integration with SD and FI, right? This is document integration with SD and FI. This is whenever we're getting invoice, that invoice value flowing or not to FI. Okay,
Okay. You are working with
for MM.
other module people, okay? Whatever
Yes,
integration scenarios are
yes,
there,
yes,
those
correct.
you have integrated. In implementation, while doing
Yes.
implementation, when you have written functional specification, when Avapor entered in your project, in
Yeah,
which phase?
for final preparation stage, in final preparation stage, he will enter for creating the output forms and just some JET reports.
Okay.
Okay. In this stage, Avapor will enter into picture.
Already SIT integration testing is completed. Why Avapor is coming after completion of your integration testing?
Sorry. Yeah, yes, correct. In realization phase only you will enter into picture. And final preference also is there. Some we have the migration is there, right? Data migration from source system to SAP. We have to upload some data, right?
Okay. Have you written any function specifications?
Yeah, I done one JET report announcement.
Okay.
For that one, I wrote the functional specifications.
Yeah, can you tell me some tickets you have resolved recently?
Yes. One of the ticket is what do we call user not getting user getting the error in the account determination.
Okay. Account determination errors, those all are not big challenges, right? Those all are small challenges, right?
Yeah, that is my low priority ticket. And one more iron priority is customer is asking, today is creating an order.
Okay.
For X material, the cost is 100 rupees, price is 100 rupees.
Okay.
Same customer, same material, you have to queue 110 price. Okay. Mm-hmm. Already we made a condition record for combination of the customer material 100 rupees.
Okay. How you?
If you go to create one more order system.
Okay.
Yeah. For that one, I created one more table combination of the customer material and customer group.
Okay.
This combination, when our customer needs different price for same customer, same material.
Okay.
In sales order header level, customer group is there. If user maintain one there, system will give 110 rupees.
Okay.
If he not give one there, system will give 100 rupees.
Okay. In the access sequence, there is exclusive indicator is there. What is the use with that?
Yes. Yeah, it will search. It is like a search strategy. Whenever they whenever they place order, right? System will check each and every table.
Okay.
Each and every table. If value found at first level.
Okay.
It will not come. If you uncheck exclusive, it will not come. It will check one by one. It will activate the last one.
Okay.
If satisfaction, if you check exclusion.
Okay.
If it satisfies the condition records, it will come with first table. Whenever the it satisfies the tables, it will come with that stage. Like for second table, it was satisfied, so it will come with second table. It activates second table.
Okay.
Deactivate the remaining tables.
Okay. What is condition exclusion and condition supplement?
Yes, condition exclusion, that field condition exclusion group concept is a condition exclusion field. I am talking about the exclusion group. Exclusion field. If you check exclusion in condition types controls, system will deactivate the below condition types in sales order.
Okay.
Condition supplementary, it is one of the it will help to add condition record to one more condition record.
Okay. Have you worked on condition update?
Yes.
Yeah, tell me why we are using condition update.
Yeah, it is also like a special discounts.
Okay.
We can restrict the condition records at order level. Based on the orders and quantity and materials. Okay. Whenever the who was the placed out of first 10 customers, they can get 50% discount.
Okay.
Whoever purchased about 10,000, whoever purchased about 10 lakhs, they will get 10,000 discount.
Okay. What is the difference between simple credit check and automatic credit check?
Yeah, in simple credit check, it will block at always order level.
Okay.
There is no risk at carries. For automatic checks, system will block at system. Whenever customer requirement exceed, it will block at order level, delivery level, PGA level. Based on the risk category, it will block.
Okay, what is the horizon period in dynamic credit check?
Origin period, yes. It will help. Origin it will have. Is there any open? Is there any open order quantity exceeds the origin date? Delivery case it exceeds the origin date. That sales order value will not update into credit management.
Okay, what is update group in credit control area?
Update group, yeah. It for which group we have to update at credit management, like if you go with 0012, okay, system will consider all open order values, open delivery, open invoice, open item values. Okay, if you go with 0018, okay, system will consider all open delivery values, okay, sorry, all open order values, invoice values, item values. The system will consider delivery values. If you go 0015,
okay,
system will consider order value, invoice value, item values. System will consider the delivery. For third party scenario, we can go with 0015. For way back, we are not going to delivery, right?
Okay, third party sales, how system created purchase request automatically? Other scenarios it is not available. Why system created purchase request automatically? What is the
yes.
main configuration
in schedule and yes in schedule and category we have the field in.
Okay, what you are filling in schedule and category?
In schedule and category order type field is there. If you go with maintain order type NB, it will generate the PR automatically whenever you're creating the sales order.
Okay. I want to put ZNB. Is it possible?
Yeah. If you create, it can possible.
Yeah. Order type is nothing but a purchase requisition type, like our quotation.
Yes.
If the MM consultant can do it, we can maintain it. Okay. Now NB is standard.
Yes.
Okay. If they want to
yes.
change it, we can change it. Okay. How I have three items are there. I want to create one item as a third party material. How system knows whether which is third party material, which is normal material?
Yeah, in Material Master, sales are two tab. We have one field is there, item category group.
Okay.
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 If for standard, 000 for standard norm is if you want to go with the third party, you have to maintain the BNS.
Okay.
Okay, we have the item category determination, the order type, item category, and item category group.
Okay.
Item usage, and item. This combination, we are going to create the item category.
Okay. I have one material. Sometimes I can use 10. Sometimes I want to use TAS. How can you change configuration? How can you do configuration part?
Yeah.
Same material.
Yeah.
I want
yes.
to create TAN. I want to create BNS.
Yes. For the scenario, I can go with the material type, item category group. Item category group is the norm. Okay.
Okay.
For item category determines configuration. What can I do here? Order type. Okay.
Okay.
Account. Item category group norm. Okay.
Okay.
Item usage, IRL, item default item category, I can maintain TAN.
Okay.
We have the like that. We can
alternate
item
category
TS. Manual item category TS. Yes, manual item category, I can maintain TS. Whenever they are creating sales order.
Okay.
Manually, I can select.
Okay. Good. What is the difference between intra company stock transfer and inter company stock transfer?
Yeah, for intra-company stock transfer we are transferring stock between two plus within company code.
Okay.
For inter-company stock transfer, we are transferring stock between टू कंपनी कोर्स।
या मिस्टर सिद्धार्थ, माय इंटरव्यू इज डन. ओके, एनीथिंग यू वांट टू नो फ्रॉम मी? हेलो
Yeah,
हेलो,
nothing.
नथिंग. या थैंक यू. और एचआर विल गेट बैक टू यू. ओके, थैंक यू.
Thank you so much.